records are from non-Muslim sources. They have not been written by Muslims. All from non-Muslim sources, from Amnesty Report, from BBC. If you go on the internet, you can cross-check. But many a time when the number is big, there may be a difference. Like today, we know how many people killed, 296, one report says 294, one says 293, so I played safe and say more than 290. The report, if it's a large number, may differ by a few here and there. If it's a small number, it's precise. All these by non-Muslim sources. In 2001, the BBC was born by IRA. But these people, they are not called as Catholic terrorists. Today, the UK government is more afraid of Muslim terrorists. I don't know from the records of the UK government how many confirmed Muslim terrorists have done bomb blast in UK. Even the London bombing of 7th July, there's no confirmed report. They are suspected to be Muslims. It's not confirmed. In which more than 50 people were killed. One report says 52, one report says 56. Therefore, I said more than 50 people were killed. Even if we agree for sake of argument that they were Muslims who did the 7th July bomb blast in the year 2005, yet they come nowhere close to IRA. IRA puts these bomb blasts to shame. They have killed hundreds and thousands of people. Yet today, the UK government is more afraid. IRA is doing since more than 100 years. But because of the advice of George Bush, Tony Blair is more afraid of the Muslim terrorists rather than the problem which is there for more than 100 years. We know from historical records that in Spain and France, the terrorist organization is ETA. They have conducted 36 attacks. And in Africa, there are so many organizations, the list is exhaustive. But the one which is worth noting and one of the most notorious is called as the Lord's Salvation Army. It's a Christian terrorist organization. They train young children to commit terrorist attacks. When we come to Sri Lanka, we know of the LTTE, Tamil Tigers. They are supposed to be one of the most notorious, most violent of all the terrorist organizations in the world. They are the people who are experts in suicide bombing. And they even take help of children, they train them, and they let them take part in suicide bombing. Normally, people are known that the Palestinians do suicide bombing, Iraq is the suicide bombing. If you historical record, the people who have popularized suicide bombing are the LTTE, Tamil Tigers. Who are they? They are Hindus. But the Indian report doesn't say Hindu terrorists, they say LTTE. When we come to India, many a times, most of the terrorist attacks that we hear of, majority of them, they talk about Kashmiri militants. Whether the attacks are right or wrong, we can discuss some other time. But how many times do we hear, and what Justice Hasbir Sareesh said, he named many of the terrorist attacks taking place in India. I wonder how many of the people in the audience have heard of them in the newspapers, how many? Those people who are involved, like honorable people like Justice Hasbir Sareesh, and those in the field are aware of it. But the general masses, we aren't aware of it. Whenever terrorist attacks are talked about, most often they're talked about Muslim terrorists. Why? In India, there are terrorist organizations belonging to almost all different religions. Almost all. We know of the Sikh terrorist organization, Brindanwala Group, in Punjab. We know that the Indian government, on the 5th of June, 1984, they took over the Golden Temple, in which 100 human beings were killed. In retaliation, a few months later, on 31st of October, 1984, the then Prime Minister, Srimati Indira Gandhi, she was assassinated by one of her security guard who was a Sikh. If you go to the South Asian terrorism portal site, not run by Muslims, run by non-Muslims, and you see the list of terrorist attacks done by all the people, the Muslims are in a minority. But that's never highlighted in the media. If you go to northeast of India, if you go to Tripura, the Christian terrorist organization exists, like ATTF, All Tripura, Tiger Force, NLFT, National Liberation Front of Tripura. They're Christians. They have killed several Hindus. Reports, if you go on the site, 4 Hindus killed, 8 Hindus killed. On 2nd October 2004, 44 Hindus were killed and several were injured by this group. They were Christians. In Assam, Ulfa. Ulfa alone, in a span of the past 16 years, from 1990 to 2006, they have conducted successfully 749 terrorist attacks. They will put the Kashmiri militants to shame. 749 confirmed terrorist attacks. But when we read in the newspaper, we only know about the Kashmiri attacks. And I remember a couple of years back, I'm called, alhamdulillah, by God's grace, by several parts of India, from several parts of the world. I had many invitations from Kashmir, but is it the right time to go, yes or no? Finally, in September 2003, I decided to go to Kashmir. And there I gave a talk in Srinagar, and they told me, the organizers, that in the past 14 years, first time the government gave permission for a public talk, and they organized my talk in polo grounds in Kashmir, in which 100,000 people attended. In all this turmoil, and the government gave me security. I was wondering, why are these people with machine guns with me? I went off to the various sites, Gulmarg, Pahalgam, gave talks, etc. Fine, I didn't think it was required. Later on, I happened to go to Assam to give talks. And the moment I land on the airport, I find security guards around me. I said, why? And there I thanked God, alhamdulillah. If they would not have been there, I wouldn't have come back here. I did not know. I did not know that so many terrorists are there in Assam. The Ulfa are trained only to target the Muslims. They're Hindus. How many times does the press, the media report about them? Because it's not tantalizing. These reports may come in the news brief. It does appear. News briefs, how many people note it? Never in the headlines. In news briefs. Amongst the organizations, terrorist organizations, the Naxalites. We know of the Maoists. The Maoists are communist. Number one terrorist attacks that have been done in India, maximum are by the Maoists. Only in Nepal, in the past 7 years, they have conducted 99 terrorist attacks. And out of the 600 districts in India, according to the Indian government, according to the site on terrorism, they say that they are present in 150 districts of India. They have done terrorist attacks in one-third parts of India. Number one, if you compare the people they have killed, the attacks they have done, compared to the Kashmir militants, it's no way comparable. The Maoists are a bigger danger for India, but yet we find that the government is more afraid of the Muslim terrorists. Why? The reason is George Bush. Just a couple of days back, on the 9th of September, an article came in Times of India, not on the front page, inside, but quite a big article, that 875 rockets, a haul of ammunition, 875 rockets, which were supposed to be supplied to the Maoists, they were intercepted. And they were confiscated. And 30 rocket launchers. Imagine, it is the biggest haul in the history of India that any terrorist organization that the government has caught. 875 rockets. They can wage a war against the Indian Army. And the DGP of Andhra Pradesh in Hyderabad, he was shocked. He said that with these rocket launchers, they can attack any police station, any tanks of the Indian government from a distance of 600 meters, from more than half a kilometer away. They can attack the Indian tanks, the Indian police station, and you can't do anything. Rocket launchers. Yet we see people are more afraid of people who have a beard, people are wearing a cap, people have trousers above the ankle. Are they more dangerous than the rocket launchers? Why? Why are they targeting the Muslims particularly? It's a question. It is a ploy of the Western media, the media controlled by the politicians. And when we analyze, we can surely say without any doubt that terrorism is not a Muslim monopoly. Not only is it not a Muslim monopoly, it is not even a specialty of the Muslims. It is not even encouraged by Islam. It is prohibited in Islam. I, being a student of comparative religion, I cannot say that all the religions say that you should not kill innocent human beings. But I can surely say that most of